الحمد لله رب العالمين، الحمد لله ذي الملك والملكوت، ذي العزة والجبروت، الحمد لله حي قيوم لا ينام، عزيز لا يضام، قهار لا يرام، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما. يقول الباري سبحانه وتعالى بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. You who believe, fear Allah as He should be feared, and die not except on a state of Islam. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most merciful, bestow upon us the gift to die on a state of Islam. Allahumma ameen ya rabbal alameen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describing the type of His noble believers in the Quran, and among this description, the way how they are devoutly obedient, standing in the night, worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, being fearing the akhirah, the hereafter, and hoping for the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Zumar, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم: أَمَّنْ هُوَ قَانِتٌ آنَاءَ اللَّيْلِ سَاجِدًا وَقَائِمًا يَحْذَرُ الْآخِرَةِ وَيَرْجُو رَحْمَةَ رَبِّهِ. It's like the parable or the example of people who are lost, confused, really living their life the way they wish, following their own whims. And the example of the one who is standing the night, devoutly obedient, and in sujood, sajida, in prostration, qa'ima, standing, reciting the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and with his objective, seeking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala pleasure. In this ayah, every true believer, sincere believer reading this ayah, he truly envy in a positive way such people who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestow upon them such a gift. And wishing for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not only wishing but beseeching Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bestow upon him such a gift. To be able to have that drive to really stand in the night and devoutly worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with long sujood and long qiyam. However, it's not really the objective for a person to come to stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the qiyam of a layl. But it's more than that. How can someone make his and her entire life in every action seeking the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? To do such a thing, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala indicated for us, this is, it's not about, you know, you can gain it by money, or you can gain it by any way of the dunya. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قَالَ هَلْ يَسْتَوِي الَّذِينَ يَعْلَمُونَ وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. Are they equal, those who know and those who do not know? Therefore, it's a question of knowledge. It's a question of knowledge. So the way to be able to attain such a gift of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because attaining with your striving, a level that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you this gift, it is a knowledge. What is this knowledge? This knowledge, it truly is not a knowledge that require, you know, deep reflection in a way that require a background or a credential of a lot of studies and years of study. But it is a knowledge that is the necessary knowledge just to be a believer. That's what the scholar they call the al-ma'lumu min ad-dini bil-darur. Now, this knowledge, if everybody know it, why we are not able for all of us to have that gift and to have that drive to really be always seeking the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in every action we do? Because this knowledge is obvious knowledge, is a necessary knowledge, but yet need to be someone that has it, you know, present in his heart and well settled and established in one's heart, and then he act upon it, and he act upon it. Now, when we see this knowledge, it might be knowledge vary based on the generation, based on the time. So what will be the specific knowledge that we need today to revive within ourselves to have that beautiful drive to really seek the pleasure of Allah. And seeking the pleasure of Allah, it means that you will be have that eagerness to honor yourself, to dignify yourself. Because seeking the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes with it all the dignification, all the way of the honoring. Because the true honoring, the true happiness, the true tranquility, the true joyful life is only sought or achieved and attained only through the seeking of the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is a fact. This is the belief of the believers, and this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala indicate to us in His Quran, and what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us, and all His guidance teaching us to take His footsteps, who take us to this objective. So getting closer to Allah, seeking the pleasure of Allah, is all the gift that you will be seeking all your entire existence. However, the knowledge that a person need to revive or to seek or to learn from the necessary knowledge depends on everyone's time. Because you might be in a time, but in all of it goes back to the same root. However, if we look at our reality and the society and the world we live in, what is the thing that the creed, the dominated creed into the world that we live in, is working to erase from our hearts? Because it is a fact. Why we always going back to our society, we're going back to the world that we live in, because it's necessary. We cannot live in a closed sphere, not caring about the society we live in. We live in the society, we are actors in the society. We are people who, you know, mingle and we have relationship with the society. Therefore, we are influenced by others. We are in a way, our subhanAllah knows the ups and downs of the society. If there is a crisis, we are part of this crisis. If there is, you know, subhanAllah, issues, we are part of this issue. So it has an impact on all of us. Therefore, it has an impact on our way of the creed, on our way of belief, on our journey to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why it's necessary always to go and check our reality. The reality that we live in, it made out of the truth, the only source, viable, certain, relevant of the truth is sciences. Is sciences, which is mean, you know, everything is within the world of the seen, the world of the seen, the thing that you can touch, the thing that you can feel, the thing that you can experiment. Without experimentation, you don't believe. These things has an effect that subhanAllah altered the iman, the most important thing, the knowledge that we need to revive the drive, to help us be eager and have that fervor to come close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to be true believers. It is the iman in the belief in the unseen. So the belief in the unseen, all of us, we have the belief in the unseen. But is this belief is well established in the heart that is translating the action? No, it's not. It's a reality. What is the gap between us and this belief in the unseen is the life that we live, in the world that we are in. We are, subhanAllah, being nurtured, instilled in us, and especially for our youth and children, that everything that is in control of your hand, that everything that you know it by science, by things that you know, exact and accuracy and so on. So the thing to rely, as we have mentioned in the last khutbah, to rely on something and seeing that you are not able to see, that you are not able to experiment, is something that it is forbidden, prohibited into the creed, dominating creed of the world of today. You know, and subhanAllah, the people who believe in the unseen, and subhanAllah, they found their life on such a belief, which is the revelation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What is the belief in the unseen? The revelation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As a matter of fact, the condition for us to benefit from the revelation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the belief in the unseen. Our gate, our door, our opening to understand the book of Allah, the understanding or the belief in the unseen. So the weaker is the belief the unseen in our heart, the farther will be from the guidance of the Quran. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in His book, in the beginning, what He said, قَالَ ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ أَلِفْ لَمِّمْ ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ. This book there is no doubt in. In it is the guidance of the believer, and it is the guidance of the believer. Who are the pious one, the righteous one? Who are the righteous one? قال الذين يؤمنون بالغيب, those who believe in the unseen. So if we do not have the condition, if this condition is weakening in our heart, then we are far from the guidance of the Quran. If we are far from the guidance of the Quran, then we are very vulnerable to the impact and the influence of the creed and the ideas and the subhanAllah, the procedure, the politics that happen is surrounding us. It's very, it's a fact that we live. It's not something that is like strange for us. This is what we live. This is what we see. This is what people, they build their motivation, they build their dreams based on aspects dictated by our world today. People, they don't believe or they have high, you know, belief or dreams to be in Jannat al-Na'im or al-Firdaus because they are able to build al-Firdaus in this earth. This is what they're teaching our kids. The Firdaus, the high, the ultimate bliss is to be achieved on earth. Wal-iyadu billah. Therefore, when we're talking about the belief of, in the unseen, as it is the core of the creed of a believer, if we do not have it, if we do not brush it, refresh it, instill in it the truth, revive it, return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then we're going to be prey to the society we live in, and we'll be like subhanAllah qal, following the followers, following every trend, listening to every loud voice, and as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala qal, when the people in the hellfire qal, وَكُنَّ نَخُوضُ مَعَ الْخَائِدِينَ, when we used to indulge in falsehood with others, people that following, imitating blindly and so on. That is not the state of other believers. That is not your state. Because all of you, if you are here, you're seeking to please Allah, you're seeking to honor yourself, you're seeking to dignify yourself. And dignification of the self require that you understand how to come to Allah, how you make your steps toward Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the belief in the unseen, today they have this factor, the psychological factor, to turn away our people from the belief in the unseen. Who believe in the unseen? They say someone, subhanAllah, he's like idiot, stupid, someone who is like very, dayyiqul fikr, someone who's like very stubborn, he does not have high horizon of thinking. If these people, they don't have that critical thinking, they do not have the thing. So subhanAllah, when we hear people like subhanAllah demonize these people who believe the unseen, is like people you need to be like kind of far from them. This is not the what they call the cool people. These people are subhanAllah regressing you, taking you to the primitive, generation. This is not how we live today. And this is a fact. So this factor, psychological factor, make our people, make despite the fact that they believe the unseen, but they are not eager to subhanAllah be attached to it, to base their life on. Now, if we are true believers, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us so, and may Allah instill sincerity in our heart, ask ourselves what will be the element to help us really check our state. How much belief of the unseen we have in our heart. Because true believers, they don't care about this allegation. True believers, they don't care to say, these people are super idiot. Said alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called us his ibad, and the last word is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Actually, we are dignified and honored to be believers, walhamdulillah. But living in the society certainly there's a negative impact on us. How can we define, how can we check, our position toward the unseen? How much we truly believe in the unseen? How much we truly act in the unseen? And we say the unseen is not about Jannah and Nar, but in your daily life. As we're going to give an example. So there's a ibadah, there's a worship, which is made like a line. A line between, for example, you are seeking safety and shielding yourself, or you want to cure the fear that you have, facing a fear that you have, seeking safety. You're trying to help yourself and to be like safe, secured. And there's a line. What is this line? Are you checking to find your safety from something that you control, that you see, that you can just call? Or you are seeking safety from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? This is very important. Because this line, when you are standing, you hear something, someone scared you, the first thing, or you feel like subhanAllah, something that is, kind of shaken, threatening your safety, what are you going to do? The first thing, subhanAllah, when you think about that easily lies or kind of a sign on the level of your belief in the answer. Are you going to withdraw or like, subhanAllah, get your safety from the thing that you touch, from the thing that you feel? Are you going to rely on your money? Are you going to rely on the people that are around you? Are you going to rely on, subhanAllah, on your authority, on your fame, on what you're going to rely? Or are you going to rely on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? That's what is defining truly how the level of the believer, the unseen, that you have in your heart. And this, by now you know what is this worship that we're talking about, is the tawakkul, the reliance on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because the reliance on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you seek from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect you, to dispose of all your affairs, and for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to safeguard you. Are you seeking the safeguard, the safety from other, some things that you control, that you see, that is tangible? Why? Because we've been influenced by the society today, by the creed, by everyone talking about science, God that knows this, even though many of the people, they believe in God, but in a God in a restricted way. He needs to be like a savior, a gracious, but not have authority or will of power. That's, you know, goes back to the humankind, or to the human, or to the elites among them. This is the society that we live in. Actually, the whole world, this is the way how they think and they believe. So if you standing and you say, subhanAllah, the tawakkul is the tawakkul, in a way, in every action you do require tawakkul. This is not, we're not talking about reliance on Allah and trusting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in getting your provision or your income or your rizq. We're talking about tawakkul that is related to every action you do. Why? Because the tawakkul is the implementation of the isti'ana. What is the isti'ana? When you say to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Fatiha, إِيَّكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّكَ نَسْتَعِينَ. Only you, Ya Allah, we worship. Only you, Ya Allah, we ask for help. So the asking for the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after you putting your effort, then you give to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all the ability to take care of you by making trust and relying on Him. So the reliance on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is indeed the implementation in reality of your asking of the isti'ana from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore, in the salah, you need tawakkul. Into the siyam, you need tawakkul. In everything that you do in your life, you need tawakkul. So you need Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help you fulfill the task in the way that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be pleased with you. Are we doing such a thing? That is the issue. That's why here, when we standing in this line, are we seeking our safety from word that we control, or seeking our safety from the unseen that is being defined to us by Allah? This is the balance where we, every one of us stands. Because the more we trust in what we have, in what we control, in what we know, that means that we do not have reliance on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if we do not have reliance on Allah, that means that we do not have a true iman in the ghaib. We do not have a true faith in the unseen. And if we do not have true faith to the unseen, then we are very weak and vulnerable to the influence of the society or the environment that we live in. We're gonna be, subhanAllah, a subject of or a prey that will be dictated on us, a lifestyle that we embrace and we adhere to. Why? Because of the shortcoming and the weakness of the al-iman bil-ghayb. This is a fact. So when you see people deserting the masajid, people, they live their lifestyle, go back to this, subhanAllah, to this structure, to this equation. The more you do not have an active iman of ghaib, faith of ghaib in your heart, the more that you are very susceptible and weak and vulnerable to the society we live in. You're gonna be following, you're gonna be like pleasing, you're gonna be cheering, and what you're cheering in things that lead in you astray. And this is a reality, this is a fact. So how can we help ourselves? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us an image in the Quran. An image in the Quran which defines for us how we should act. It's an image in the small, subhanAllah, scene in the Quran. When Musa alayhi salam was facing the magician, قالوا يا موسى إما أن تلقي وإما أن نكون أول ألقى. Are you going to throw or are we going to be the first? We're going to do that. قال بل ألقوا. Said go ahead and do it. قال فإذا حبالهم وعصيهم يخيل إليه من سحرهم أنها تسعى. That their ropes and their sticks From their magic, it appears to Musa that they are true snakes. This is the world that we live in. What you see is an illusion. They tell you this is the path of happiness is an illusion. Wallahi, they're lying on you. This is the path of tranquility, they're lying on you. And every other day they bring you, subhanAllah, a new path. For everyone who has an issue in the way they look, in the way how, subhanAllah, they want, in the way what type of achievement that they do, every day that there is a new person who gonna dictate on them in new policy that it truly take them to what they want, is an illusion. This is exactly as Musa alayhi salam looking at these ropes and sticks that turn inside, with his eyes, he sees them, subhanAllah, snakes. فَأَوْجَسَ فِي نَفْسِهِ خِيفَةً مُوسَى. Musa, subhanAllah, had a fear inside him. He got really scared. This is our situation in our life. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him, this is the answer. قَالَ لَا تَخَفْ إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْأَعْلَى وَأَلْقِ مَا فِي يَمِينِكَ تَلْقَفْ مَا صَنَعُوا إنما صنعوا كيد ساحر ولا يفلح الساحر حيث أتى. Up to here is all unseen. Do not have fear. Do not fear. That's one. You are the highest. That's two. And throw what you have in your hand. These, your brother, respected sister, this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling you. And you don't have anything in your hand. You're still seeing them snakes. You're still seeing the world of the illusion deluding you to tell you this is the right, this is the truth, this is how it should be. All of these other people are idiots, stupid, and so on. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying to us in this scene, three orders, all of them in the unseen. قَالَ لَا تَخَفْ. Why should you fear? قَالَ وَلَا تَهِنُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا وَأَنْتُمُ الْأَعْلَوْنَ إِن كُنْتُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ. Do not be weakened, do not be sad, and you are the highest if you are true believers. Therefore, the fact to have fear, if you are a true believer, if you have fear, you have a problem with your belief. قَالَ إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْأَعْلَى. You are the high. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is dignifying you and elevating you. You are the superior. Why? Because you are a servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why you do not get your pride and your might and your strength because you are a servant of Allah? Why you want to be fame or you want to be a follower of so and so, or you have to have a title? You already been dignified, you already been honored. وَأَنْتَ الْأَعْلَى. قَالَ وَأَلْقِ مَا فِي يَمِينِكَ. And throw what you have in your hand. It was an unseen, it was still in the hand of Musa, it's still wood, it's still wood. So he has to believe in Allah. He saw it once turn into snake. But when he has it, subhanAllah, he's reliance, that is the tawakkul. قَالَ أَلْقِهَا يَا مُوسَى. When he throw it, subhanAllah, hear the fulfillment of the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hear the manifestation of the truth. Hear Allah's power is seen with your own eyes. And this is, subhanAllah, what we are required to do in this life. قَالَ subhanAllah, the three orders. All of them in the unseen. But when you make tawakkul and you trust in Allah and you put all your effort, you don't have to fear. Fight the fear that you have in your heart. Fight the fact to really have your self-esteem that is founded on you being servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Bring me these two things. Then do your action. The action is going to be very easy. Just throw. That's it. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take charge of everything else. So you see from this scene, dear brother, respected sister, how can we bring back to revive that belief in the unseen to help ourselves, elevated ourselves? You are being already elevated. So if you are low, because we have lowered ourselves, we lowered ourselves. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honored you. So if you turn away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that is a fact, that is a reality. We are disgracing ourselves. So in brief, what are the way how can we revive this type of iman, this great worship of tawakkul in its comprehensive way? It's a comprehensive way, reliance in every action you do. As we said in Musa alayhi salam, you do all what you can by fulfilling the condition that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala order you to do, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fulfill for you his promise. The first thing, dear brother, respected sister, is to put a question mark on our Islam. It's a fact and a reality. Are we true Muslim to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Because we'll never be able to make tawakkul and reliance on Allah if we have a shaky Islam, shaky surrounding to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وقال موسى لقومه, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala قال, قال وقال موسى لقومه إن كنتم تؤمنون بالله فعليه توكلوا إن كنتم مسلمين. If you truly believe in Allah, then put your reliance on Allah. Allah will take care of you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will shield you from Fir'aun. If you are true Muslim, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us from the two men with Musa alayhi salam, when the people of Musa, they refused to enter to the Ard al-Muqaddasa, to the sacred land, and they said, قال رجلان من الذين يؤمنوا من يخافون يخافون أنعم الله عليهما أدخلوا عليهم الباب. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, these two men, believers, from the people of Musa, they said to their people, if you just go to the gate, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you victory. If you are true believers. So here the condition, your step that you're going to do for with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the unknown, that what requires Islam. So if we do not make our step to Allah into the unknown, believing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to take care of us, then we do not have iman. We truly have the substance of the iman, but we don't have that active iman, that dynamic iman to help us grow, to help us honor ourselves. قَالَ إِن كُنْتُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ. So imagine if the people of Musa that just went to the gate, they will have Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them victory. That's why the companion of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Ghazwat Badr said, we will not tell you are the people of Musa. They said, go and your Lord fight, and here we are staying. We will tell you, go and your Lord, and we are with you, Ya Rasulullah. Whatever you take us, we'll go with you. That's the obedience. So this is the first thing, a question mark on our surrendering to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In a very truthful, humble way. It's not like someone to like blaming ourselves or cursing ourselves. وَالْعِيَذُ بِاللَّهِ. This is a fact, this is a reality. Many people today, so sometimes, for example, say, oh, so-and-so, he turned this way. He said, subhanAllah, was he a Muslim at the first place? Someone embracing, for example, the movement of LGBT, and he's a Muslim. He said, he's not Muslim truly. I mean, do not bring the name of Islam. The name of Islam has its characteristic and has its condition. That's why today we are sharing this talk to put a question mark on Islam. Does not mean that we are not Muslim, but to true Muslim, they have subhanAllah characteristic. They have something to drive them. They have their motivation. They have their dreams. Do we have such a dreams and motivation? If it's no, let's be truthful ourselves. Let's be humble and modest for ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us and revive the iman in our heart. The second one, it is the basis and the foundation of everything in this topic, which is قَالَ لَا يُسِيبَنَا إِلَّا مَا كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَنَا. Nothing will happen to them. Nothing will befall on us except what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has decreed for us. This is subhanAllah what would help you in your life, navigate all the challenges, all your problems in your life. قُلْ لَنْ يُصِيبَنَا. This is the foundation. Nothing will inflict us. Nothing will befall on us except what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has decreed for us. And on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put your reliance. وَعَلَى اللَّهِ فَلْيَتَوَكَّلِ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. And this is in Surah At-Tawbah. The third one is how to get this. How to get this. So if you have the condition, I will need to surrender more to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The second is, I need to instill in my heart and revive and practice the fact that nothing can happen to me except what Allah has decreed. So why I'm mad? If I have a problem, we go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As a matter of fact, Salat al-Istikhara, it helps us to practice this creed in our heart. The third, how I can get to there. It's very simple, your brother, respected sister, is to look at the manifestation of the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in our life. It does not again require deep study. When you say Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ar-Rahman, so is your objective. The most perfect attribute of ar-Rahman is ar-Rahman. So if you want to be a merciful, you have to have your example, which is the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is your guide. That is your light. If you want to be someone generous, that is your light. However, if you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is al-Aziz. What is al-Aziz? What is the Almighty? What is the most merciful? How can I understand it? How can I have my heart to be soaked with this name so I will act upon it? So when someone will be, subhanAllah, attacking me, say, Al-Aziz is with me. Am I able to do such a thing? Do we have the iman, the faith to really inquire Al-Aziz when we have problem? That is in fact Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala teaching us. In very brief, if you go to Surah Al-Shu'ara, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the example. The example that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned. He said, for the example of Musa alayhi salam. The example of Musa, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Shu'ara, you say it like repeated more than 10 times. إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَةٌ وَإِنَّ أَكْثَرَهُمْ وَمَا أَكْثَرَهُمْ بِمُؤْمِنِينَ وَإِنَّ رَبَّكَ لَهُوَ الْعَزِيزُ الرَّحِيمُ. And your Lord is the Almighty, the Most Merciful. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not ask you to understand what is Al-Aziz in depth, in linguistic, in attribute, and Al-Rahim. He's telling you, just read the story, you're going to know what is Al-Aziz Al-Hakim. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us about the fear of the Bani Israel and the attack of Fir'aun and his soldier, subhanallah, they got so scared and said, that's it, this is our end. So Musa alayhi salam said, nay, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with me is guide me. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala inspired to Musa, and he hit the sea with his stick, and subhanallah, it departed and opened a way. And subhanallah, the opening of the way, here you're going to understand Al-Aziz al-Rahim. Al-Aziz, the Almighty, he defeated the arrogance of Fir'aun and his army. Al-Aziz, who had to have bring out Fir'aun and his people from their palaces, from their, subhanallah, from their, you know, gardens and everything, to come and to be drowned and dead into the sea. That's Al-Aziz. Al-Rahim is the one who make a way in the sea for the believer. Al-Rahim who give them tranquility. Al-Rahim who satisfy their heart to see those people who have been oppressing them for years and years to drown in front of them. Al-Rahim who save them, all of them. Therefore, you know what is Al-Aziz al-Rahim. You know the manifestation of the Aziz al-Rahim as real in the story of Musa. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala kept saying it after every story. After the story of Nuh, and after the story of Hud, and after the story of Salah, and after the story of Lut, and after the story of Shu'aib. And then after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, and he is Al-Aziz al-Rahim, the one who sent down to you the Qur'an. The one who sent Jibreel to send to put this Quran in the heart of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Al-Aziz al-Rahim, then ya Muhammad, put your trust on Al-Aziz al-Rahim. Al-Aziz al-Rahim, the Almighty, and this is subhanAllah how we help our heart to be soaked with these names, to give us strength, to give us power. Then when you pray to Al-Aziz al-Rahim. Then قَالَ وَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى الْعَزِيزُ الرَّحِيمُ. The one who see when you stand and your prostration goes back to the devoutly obedient. That was the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. إِنَّهُ هُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. He's the all-hearing, the all-knowing. If you know such a thing, then you revive that iman of the unseen in your heart, and you'll be ready to have the strength and power to have an active iman to drive you to be seeking the pleasure of Allah. You'll be then honoring yourself. You'll be then dignifying yourself. You'll be then one of the most powerful person in the whole universe. Why? Simply because you are a humble servant of Allah. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروا الغفور الرحيم. بسم الله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على النبي المصطفى أما بعد. In a brief summary, we need the reviving of that belief in the unseen. Not to be passive, but to be something that you rely on, because this unseen is in the hand of Allah. The unknown is a creation of Allah. The unknown is in destiny of Allah. The unknown is in the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if you are scared from the unknown and rely on the physical world to help us, then we don't believe in the all-knowing. We don't trust the Almighty, and we are not sure if He is truly the Most Merciful subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's not what we say, but this is our action saying, which is mean our heart who is translating, or the action are the translation in of what we have in our heart. So in our heart we have a very poor iman, faith in the unseen. Now we said this knowledge, and we talked about the tawakkul, and we talked about the condition, and we talked about how can we, through the stories of the Quran, how can really revive it, how can really, you know, interact with it. What is the first step? The first step, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, He called the people of knowledge, He called them the people of understanding. This is a reminder for the people of understanding. How can we be people of understanding to benefit of all what we have said, to benefit from the book of Allah, from the guidance of the Quran, to revive our iman in the unseen, and then to really strengthen our tawakkul and reliance on Allah in every action we do. How can we be people of reason, people of understanding? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the same surah gave us the definition. قَالَ أَلَّذِينَ يَجْتَنِبُ الطَّاغُوتَ, those who shun themselves from the crookedness, from the false gods, وَأَنَابُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ, and they turn in inaba to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those who have the glad tidings, give glad tidings to my servant, who listen to the reminder. الَّذِينَ يَسْتَمِعُونَ الْقَوْلَ فَيَتَّبِعُونَ أَحْسَنَهُ, and they follow the best of it. أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ هَدَاهُمُ اللَّهُ, those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have guided, أُولَٰئِكَ هُمْ أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ, those are the people of understanding. So to be one of the people of understanding, start with very simple action. To listen to the reminder. To listen with an open heart. To listen with an attentive ear. If you listen to the vain talk, you cannot be from these people. Therefore, you cannot revive the iman of the unseen. Therefore, you cannot be from the mutawakkilin. If you listen to the gossip, if you listen, subhanAllah, everything that you listen to, music or things, that subhanAllah, what is going to its effect is just to cover your heart. Then you cannot be able to be from the people of reason. So it's a very simple fact. Start by listening. الَّذِينَ يَسْتَعُونَ, those who listen. And the people who are being cast in hellfire, they said, we wish we have listened. لَوْ كُنَّا نَسْمَعُ أَوْ نَعْقِلْ مَا كُنَّا فِي أَصْحَابِ السَّيِّرِ. If we have listened and reasoning. So the reasoning happened after the listening. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, this is a reminder for those who have hearts or led or gave an attentive ear. For this reason, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala complimented the jinn who they have listened to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. قَالُوا إِنَّا سَمِعْنَا, you see, سَمِعْنَا قُرْآنًا عَجَبًا, we have heard an amazing recitation, Qur'an. Guides to the guidance or guides to the uprightness. يَهَدِي إِلَى الرُّشْدِ فَآمَنَّا بِهِ, we believed in it and we do not associate any partner with Allah. It started with سَمَعْ, they only listened, subhanAllah. So some of the jinn are far away from us in their iman, in their piety, which subhanAllah, but just listening, it changed their heart. And we are listening the Quran every day. Why it does not change our heart? Why? Because the heart is absent, oblivious, heedless. Dear brother, respected sisters, let's bring back our heart. Let's revive the iman of the unseen in our heart by just simple action that you start with. Just watch what you're listening. Watch what you're listening to help yourself be honored. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from those being honored. Allahumma akrimna bil iman ya arhamna ya arhamar rahimin. Allahumma aj'alna min ibadika al-mutawakkilin. Allahumma aj'alna min alladhina yastami'una al-qawla fayattabi'una ahsanah. Allahumma aj'alna min ulil albab. Allahumma aj'alna min ibadika al-qanitin. المنيبين يا رحيم يا رحمن يا كريم. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا أجمعين وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين. وأخيم الصلاة يرحمكم الله.